Thanks. So I gotta mention this guitar that I'm playing. I don't usually gig with this guitar. It has no electronics. But this is built by a woman named Linda Manzer up in Toronto. Incredible builder who, I don't know if any of you catch Bruce Coburn the other night at the Auburn Public Theater. Wow, there was a guitar lesson. Amazing. He plays a guitar a lot like this one. Linda Manzer also builds Pat Metheny's acoustic guitars. And I just feel lucky to own this instrument. And I could show you this. It's probably a little hard to see from there, but on this side, it's thin. On the other side, it's flared out, has a wedge body. So it feels smaller than it actually is. The arm goes over the narrower side, which is super comfortable. But this guitar has this incredible bass and makes arrangements like that especially fun to play, I gotta say. Other thing I should just mention too, because I'm tuning down a lot, and that song, I've tuned the fifth string to G and the sixth all the way down to C. These days I'm tuning down more and more in the bass strings. And I started using bluegrass gauge strings. I use light gauge phosphor bronze strings forever, D'Addario, on this guitar. And I recently did an interview with Sean Colvin, who's a great, you know, guitarist, singer-songwriter. And she was talking about using bluegrass gauge strings, which are mediums on the bass and lights on the treble side. And this has been fantastic. And the light bulb kind of went off. She was a very powerful rhythmic player. The bass is really important to her, and having a sort of beefier bass, she felt like it was really important. And I tried it, and it just felt like this guitar was made for that. And I don't know if Terry from Beat Street is here or not, but he helped me get my other guitar, my Taylor guitar, set up with strings like that too, really sounding nice.
How heavy of a gauge do you use when you say that heavy, like medium, like what gauge?
I can't remember the numbers of that, but it's like the fifth and sixth, the bottom fourth, three strings are like what they would normally be on a medium set. I can't remember what the numbers are. But I could check.
Oh, I can figure out. Thank you.
Yeah. So with tunings, I tend to only really retune the bass strings for the most part. A couple reasons for that. It's a lot easier for performing to do that. I don't have to, although it's probably seemed like I've been tuning endlessly up here because my guitar's kind of adjusting new strings. But it's a lot easier to change tunings if they're just in the bass rather than doing alternate tunings and changing them all or many of them. And I'm very much of an improvisational player. I don't really play things the same way, so I like having the familiarity of you know, a lot of the strings in standard tuning. But I do have a few songs in alternate tunings, and wanted to do one of them for you. Invite Wendy Ramsey to join me singing on this song. Yeah? Bird song. Yeah. So Wendy and I play together as a duo sometimes, and also in a trio with the amazing percussionist Josh DeCaney, an acoustic trio. So, anyway, this song is so much fun to sing with Wendy's harmony, so I asked her to come and join me for this one. We have, while I'm mentioning it, a few trio shows this month, including this coming Saturday at Creekside, and later in the month on the 28th, the Thursday night at Shifty's. Both those are free shows, so I have some gig cards over here, which you feel free to grab if you like. Busy week this week, opening also for Peter Mulvey and Jeffrey Foucault at the Nelson Odeon on Friday night. And if you've never heard Peter Mulvey, he is one unbelievable guitarist, fingerstyle guitarist, great songwriter. Highly recommended to check that show out too.
You came to my youth center once in Camillus.
Oh yeah, I was there that day.
Oh, yeah.
Peter Mulvey. So this is another Dead song called Bird Song, which was written originally about Janis Joplin, in memory of Janis Joplin. And a lot of the song is on one chord. It's kind of a modal sort of sound. Got a bit of a drone thing going on, which made me immediately think of Dadgad tuning, D-A-D-G-A-D. So that was the way I wound up arranging it and teaching it on the Homespun DVD here. So here's Birdsong.
Don't you cry, dry your eyes.
you hear that same sweet song again, will you know why? Anyone who sang the tune so sweetly is passing by. Fly through the night. Don't cry now. Don't you cry. Don't you cry anymore. La la la. Sleep in the stars. Snow and rain, snow and rain.